think that all teenagers are addicted to social media, okay? And I was like, my kid isn't addicted to social
media. This is hysterical, though.
Earlier, we were talking about this, and I was like, well, you know what?
She's interested in technology.
She likes technology.
But not really social media. I mean, she might be like, she's always looking at memes.
Yes, and she's always on Instagram, and she's always on YouTube.
And I went, that's social media.
I'm old, y'all.
Like, I don't know what you thought social media was, like smoke signals? Like, what did you think social media, like carrier pigeons? Like, what did you think social, oh, she doesn't send letters to people. No, that's social media. Yeah. YouTube is social media.
Yeah, I didn't even think that.
Memes. Those were posters when you were a child, or actually tablets.
Tablets. Well, cave drawings.
Cave drawings,
yes,
when you were
right,
young.
Right.
You were young. What was Play-Doh like? Anyway, the reality is, according to an article in The Guardian, there's a quiet backlash brewing among teens. 63% of teens say they'd be happy if social media had never been invented.
Interesting.
Plus, the percentage of young people who say social media is important has dropped from 66% to 57%.
Yeah, more and more teens are quitting it altogether, apparently.
That's right.
And you know what? And they're saying that, you know, possibly too much social media harms teens.
Well, we have a guest here to help us navigate this, Dr. Nancy Irwin. Mm-hmm. She's an addiction and mental health expert. Thank you very much for being here, Nancy.
Thank you,
Nancy.
Thank you. A pleasure, ladies.
So how much social media is too much?
I would say it differs with each individual teenager, and it's up to parents to regulate that so it's monitored, so they moderate it. It's not altogether bad. But it's it has to do with how much time they're spending. Yeah. If their grades are plummeting, if it's affecting their sleep or their appetite or their mood, which can be many factors affecting a teen's mood anyway,
right,
of course.
Right.
But if they're excessively irritable, more so than ever, and you see them, if they can't even sit through a movie without grabbing that phone and see who texted them or call them, or they got a click or an Instagram flag, if they can't get through that, then there may be a problem.
You know what I am curious about? Because we just, this last year, in the sixth grade, got our daughter a phone just so that she could have it because she was going to a school much further away from home, right?
Smart.
But now I'm curious, I want to know, should I take her phone away at night when she goes to bed? Should she charge it someplace further away from her? Because I think she might be on her phone looking things up at, you know, late at night, and I just don't know. I don't know,
okay.
Nancy.
Great opportunity to make this a family issue. And how about every member in the family or the household puts their phones in one particular place and they charge them together?
You mean so that everybody wouldn't be able to look at stuff in the middle of the night on their phone?
Because here's the deal. As we know, peer pressure is enormous for teens.
Yes.
For all of us, actually. But 50% of their environmental pressure influence comes from parents.
Really?
So if kids have a good relationship with their parents or caregivers, there's a great chance they're going to factor that in, and they may go toward what mommy or daddy would do rather than their peers.
Unless, of course, mommy is on Facebook like 24/7.
Exactly. That's what I'm saying.
I'm just throwing it out there that I'm interested to see if you implement this program.
Yes.
So what are some of the positives about social media, though, for teens?
Well, it is a generational thing, and they might want to keep up. It is a cultural thing, and there's nothing wrong with knowing what's going on in the world. Also, there's some groups, you know, specifically, you know, Elizabethan music groups that people join, or, of course, I have a mental health one. Things like that where you can learn and connect with like-minded people, and then you can develop a chat room and things like that. So there is some educational factors at play there.
Right.
That's a good thing.
Yeah.
But when kids, look, we're all socially comparative creatures by nature anyway, but if they're looking excessively out there for the world to tell them what they should be doing, thinking, feeling, that's an issue.
If it's influencing your child to make choices in their active daily life,
absolutely,
then we need to take a look at that.
Yes.
Because I also saw that, you know, you treat trauma. Do you think that social media is traumatizing our kids in ways that we don't understand yet?
It certainly can be. Mm. Look at some of the cases that have made the headlines of kids being bullied mm-hmm. and committing suicide as a result
yes.
of this. That's trauma
yeah.
for all of the other people in the family. And of course, the kid was traumatized before they were driven to that suicidality.
Right.
It's horrendous.
Yeah.
And just a note, there are a lot of people, a lot of kids who unknowingly are sending titillating pictures of themselves,
right.
receiving it from yes. others.
Wow. Thank you so
Thank
much.
You so much.
Thank you.
Me Time with Frangela.